So the EcoReco electric scooter just arrived, and I was going to do a quick unboxing just to show what comes in the package and give you an idea of what to expect. Just kind of got a couple boxes here. I'm going to go ahead and get this stuff out. So I just lifted the EcoReco out. Comes with a large size t-shirt. I'm a medium, so I might donate that. But here is the scooter itself, and you can see it's kind of sealed up in a plastic bag right now, but it's got these little spring shocks on the front, the tires feel kind of soft, and yeah, I'm going to dig in a little bit deeper. And this is the final stage of unpacking, so I've removed the plastic, and there's a little piece of cardboard to keep it from banging as it was shipped, and then there's this little box, which includes a getting started guide and a battery charger. And then you look for this little lever right here and you push that down and it sort of unlocks the front. Lift that whole thing up like this. And then these bars flip up. You kind of pull that thing down, secure like that. And now it looks like a scooter, right? There's the throttle. Sweet. And they said make sure it's off. And then, can you see that little cap right there? That's where you charge the battery. Oh, and here's the kickstand. So I'm going to go ahead and get this thing charging. So I'm charging the EcoReco scooter, kind of laying down on the floor right here. The easiest way to transport this thing is with the handle folded, because it sort of works like a handle. You pick the bike up using that. You can kind of hear the charger. It's got a little fan. And once it's done, that's what happens. That light turns green, that little LED right there. So let's take it out and talk a little bit more about the specs. So this is the EcoReco M3 electric scooter. It's about 34 pounds, which sounds nice, but you know, when you lift it up, it does weigh a bit, and that's because there's a battery right there in that platform. It's got a 250-watt motor back here in that rear wheel section, which is pretty impressive for a scooter. Full-size electric bikes often use 250-watt motors, especially in the EU, but they often have pedal assist. So it feels very capable. I've been kind of climbing the driveway here and everything, no problem. And it goes pretty fast. I've almost reached 20 miles per hour. They've kind of got like a chart that talks about your average speed and your range on this thing. It has a lithium iron phosphate battery pack at 36 volts, 8 amp hours, which is pretty good. I mean, again, that's sort of full-size electric bike specs right there almost. Anyways, they say if you're cruising at around 8 miles per hour, you could get a 19-mile range. If you're going regular speed at 13 miles per hour, you could get a 23-mile range. And that's interesting to me. I guess that's operating at the best efficiency for the motor. At that higher speed, you'll actually get to go further. And then on performance, you know, if you're going 18 miles per hour, you're only going to get a 17-mile range. Those are all still, you know, pretty good distances. They say the maximum load weight for this is 260 pounds. So if you weigh more than that, it doesn't sound like this is going to work for you. And yeah, that's kind of the outline of the specs. Folding this thing is pretty cool. It's got this big lever right here. So you kind of pull on this, that unlocks it, and then you can press on this lock right here. And when you do that, it's hard to do with one hand. There we go. This whole top bar folds down like this, and it locks. Okay, so now it's in lock position, and I can actually, you know, lift the whole thing up just using my hand like that. So, you know, it's pretty well designed, I think. It's even got those nice little shock absorbers in the front, which you do notice when you're riding around. It's got this sort of adjustment here, so you can slide the handlebars up further from this hole to this hole right here. So depending on your height, this thing is pretty versatile. For a little scooter, you know, it's done right. It's really high level of quality, and it comes in all these recycled, you know, paper boxes and everything that's meant to be really environmentally friendly. And even the battery chemistry, lithium iron phosphate, doesn't have as high of energy density as like other forms of lithium ion, like cobalt per se, but it's
It's meant to charge and discharge very quickly. And that was the other thing. They say you can get 80% charge in 2.5 hours, full charge 100% in like 4.5 hours. So that's good. Anyway, this is supposed to be more environmentally friendly to produce. So, you know, they've been pretty thoughtful about the design, having only really carried this thing around so far. It's a little heavy for me. It's not something that, you know, kids pulling this around, they're going to be like kind of leaning to one side because it is a little bit heavier, but it's pretty compact. Once it's folded up, you can toss this thing in your trunk. No problem. You can toss several of these, or if you're, you know, trying to go a mile or two to the train station, this is much easier to carry on than a full-size electric bike. It's just not super duper light. You know, it's not, it does cramp your style a little bit carrying this thing around. But anyway, it's a lot of fun. It's actually very, very fast. And, most electric bikes that are like folders and stuff, they only go like 15 miles per hour. And for this to go, you know, closer to 20 is pretty amazing. So here we are just looking at the M3. I mentioned before that it's got a 250-watt motor there in the rear, and it looks like that thing has a peak output of 750 watts, which is just amazing. I'm just still, having ridden this around a little bit, it feels really cool, fast, and efficient. You know, there is some noise associated with it, so I'm going to go ahead and, turn it on and kind of show you that. There we go. Holding the button. Might try to hang this around. I'm going to coast the driver real quick. And here's the motor. Whoa. It's a little bit less stable than a full-size bike. So I got going about, 10 miles per hour there. Again, I'm doing this with one hand, using that finger throttle right there. It's fun, but, it's definitely a little bit more squirrely than a full-size bicycle. For $1,000, this is pretty inexpensive. There are very few electric bikes that are, that inexpensive and portable like this. They say it's got like a 23-mile range. Again, sort of that top speed is around 20 miles per hour, but I'm not sure I would want to go that fast all the time just because you could fall hard on this thing. But it is a ton of fun. You kind of heard the motor there. It's not super loud. It's a neat product. Yeah, that's the EcoReco M3 electric scooter. For more on this and other electric vehicles, specifically bikes, check out electricbikereview.com. And I'll see you there.